shake, baby.
Yeah. Well, I'm Jerry Phillips, and I'm the son of the, I guess you could call him legendary son, Sam Phillips. He started Sun Record Company. Well, all right. I made it through the rainstorm to Sun International Corporation. Glad to be here. Look, I'm going to see John Singleton. If you'll let me come in.
Looks like we got a... somebody in a truck in my parking spot here. Somebody called the tow truck.
Hey, Phyllis.
Hey, Jerry.
How you doing?
Great to see you.
Good to see you, too. It's been a long time.
I know.
Hey, I've got a 10 o'clock appointment with John.
Okay, let me buzz him and he'll be right out.
All right, great, thank you.
Can't you read, man? Can't you read? Well, hello, Jerry. Welcome back to Sun Records, Nashville.
Rock on, rock on.
You don't regret we moved it from Memphis, do you?
Not at all.
Okay, well, come on, let's have a tour.
Let's do it, I'm excited.
Okay, Jerry, let's go in this room here. I think Sam and Shelby spent a lot of time in here trying to figure out the record business.
I'm sure they did.
Yeah.
I think they figured it out. It's a lot of hard work going into all of this stuff, man. A lot of passion, a lot of hard work.
Yeah.
Man, you know, Sam was working on a shoestring budget, but things started happening for him. You know, after Rocket 88, he started getting a little money in there, and that's when things started really, really happening for him. Then Elvis came on, of course. Well, cool stuff, man. Cool stuff. I like this a lot. I don't know if y'all can see it or not, but this was a great picture of my father with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 separate CD compilations in there, right, John?
Yeah, it's all the Sun singles.
All the Sun singles. But that's a great concept.
Yeah, oh yeah.
A lot of great music on these walls, no doubt about it.
Come on, Jerry, let's go check out Shelby's desk. We might find a hit in there that never was out.
I know, a lot of good business went on in here, didn't it?
Yeah.
We're in Shelby's office here, and this is a long and winding story, I know, but you know, the recording magic happened in Memphis, and then you guys bought the masters and the label and continued your own magic with it.
This area here was where Shelby was when we first moved into this building in 1968. And from this desk, he sold probably 2 million Harper Valley PTA records off of it, because he was doing everything. He almost one-man guy.
You know, just imagine the thrill of being an independent guy like Sam or Shelby, and then all of a sudden you get a 1 or 2 million seller on your hands. I mean, it's like some kind of dream, you know, that you dream about when you get into the music business.
Shelby had his own magic, and evidently in this room, because this is where he first met Jenny C. Riley and a lot of other artists that, you know, were looking for a label. And so certain amount of magic was spinning in here also.
What we got in here, John? We got a bunch of stuff on the walls that looks like it makes certificate of appreciation.
Various things that mostly apply to Shelby there, yeah.
Here it is, Before the Next Teardrop Falls. What a great song. If I'd have written that, I'd be really proud. Johnny the Man in Black. Don't know exactly what this is, but...
one of Shelby's favorite things in his later days was a slot machine, yeah. Wanna go see the kitchen?
Is there any tequila in the refrigerator?
Yeah.
Let's go.
If not, we'll get some.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, Jerry, let's go visit the kitchen here.
All right. I haven't spent much time in here, John, to be honest with you.
Well, this is more Shelby's atmosphere in here. He used to occasionally cook up red beans and rice. And,
oh, yeah?
And not much more than that, though.
John, you got a lot of stuff on the walls in here, and some of it I don't really recognize or what it is, but what are some of these over here?
The top one here on the right, that's Shelby and his oldest son, Steve. Next to him is Clyde McFadder, who is a great R&B artist that Shelby worked with at Mercury. And to the left is Shelby and Johnny Holiday, who was the Elvis of France for many years. This picture was taken in Paris. Down below, it's Shelby and Jenny C. Riley around the time Harper Valley PTA was done. And Then the middle one here is Brooke Benton, another great artist that Shelby worked with when he was at Mercury. And then another picture of Shelby and Jenny C. Riley, trying to decide if they want to do that song.
All this, you got posters and stuff up here, looking pretty cool. Those look like from shows and stuff. Show posters, probably.
Yeah, that's what those were.
So what? When you guys aren't drinking, what do you keep in the refrigerator?
Leftovers.
Well, John, it looks like you guys had a lot of hit country singles in these charts on the wall.
Yeah, the bottom layer, it looks like mostly songs that we published, like Before the Next Teardrop Falls and Turn the World Around the Other Way.
Yeah. I want to know what the story is behind this golden 8-track. That's.
I don't know if I can accurately
describe that. Jenny C. Riley?
Yes, Jenny C. Riley, and it says $250,000 in sales. That's what it took to get that gold 8-track. Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
I've never seen a gold 8-track before.
This is me and Shelby at the bottom and our parents at the top, at certain levels of age.
Yeah.
It varies.
Is that you?
Yeah.
Wow. Pretty cool, man.
Jerry, let's go look at some of the other parts of the building.
All right, man. You know, over the years I've been here some, but I'm more familiar with the Sun in Memphis and the Sample Recording Studio there that we have, and I sure would like to see what's going on here, too.
Oh, come on, we'll show you. Yeah. This is what I've been operating out of for many years.
You know, John, I've been in here quite a few times on your side of the building here, and but I've never really looked at all of the stuff you got here. Is that you, Sam, and Shelby there?
That's us in New York in 2002. They had a party at a club up there, and Sam spoke, and some of these pictures are from that. That's a picture of us in the club. My wife and Shelby and Sam all on stage. And this is one of my favorites. Which one is Jesus?
This one. He looks like he's talking. Well, my dad could talk. He could preach.
Yeah, he could preach. Yeah.
You know, he could preach.
Yeah. And,
you know?
Yeah.
Any minute.
Let's come in and look at my office a little bit while we're here. Yeah.
I've been here a few times, but you know, I know when Shelby passed on or got sick or whatever that you kind of started running the ship here, and you made a lot of deals from back that chair back there, hadn't you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. A lot of licenses have passed through here, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and a lot of money, too.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
I open up the mail every day. Yeah, okay.
Where are we going? More places? Yeah.
Yeah, well, let's go in here and we can wander through some more stuff here. Let's go in and step in the old studio here for a minute.
All right, I'll get the door for you.
Thank you.
It's been a long time since I've been in here, man.
Still about the same.
I love studios, you know. I do.
Come on in, Jerry. This is was originally our recording studio. Lasted from about 1969 through the early 80s. It was private. We didn't rent it out. It was just stuff we did here. My brother Shelby kind of gave him the details of how he wanted it done. He liked this higher control room, and
yep.
I think he got that idea from Motown Studio. And then these cabinets here is where we kept all the masters. And the way it is now is the way it was when it became our warehouse for merchandise.
Yeah, this looks a little bit like the Sam Phillips Recording Studio. Actually, these baffled things on the wall there, and then the ceiling at the Sun Studio had some wavy type. I remember being in here now. Cool place.
We recorded artists, you know, like Jenny C. Riley and Johnny Adams here. Carol Channing, French Elvis, Johnny Holiday, and Barbara Eden. She was in she was a star in the movie Harper Valley PTA, yeah. But it was actually never a big hit recorded here.
Yeah.
These are album covers, and a lot of the records that went into those were actually recorded here.
Really? That's quite a few.
Then there were a lot of the Sun albums like Johnny Cash and Jerry Lee Lewis that we repackaged after we bought Sun, yeah. Why don't we go up and look at the control room?
Love to.
Ready?
Love to.
Okay.
I like control rooms.
Live to see the lights of town. I wasted my time when I would try.
Come on in to the control room.
All right. Hey. Not bad. Not bad at all. Been a while since I've been here.
Yeah, it looks a little different probably than the last time you were here.
It does.
Yeah.
I like it though. Got some nice old machines in here.
Looking back at history, aren't we?
Yeah. We are.
Yeah, well, this is where, of course, Shelby, when he was producing, he would sit here with the engineer, and he liked this elevated control room, so he could look down on the band and the singers.
Yeah.
And this is also the area where, when digital came to being, we converted most of our masters from analog to digital in this room.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
When you guys came and picked all the tapes up from us at the Sun and at Phillips, you came and brought them over here and transferred them all.
Yeah. We sure did.
Yeah. Well, it worked out pretty good, didn't it?
I think it did, yeah. I believe it did. Jerry, thank you so much for coming over and participating in this tour. You know, we couldn't have done it without you, man, because you got all that original knowledge of what went on at Sun Records, what Sam Phillips was about, and what he did, and how we've all benefited from it.
Well, it's been great, man. I've really enjoyed it. It's been a while since I've been here, but I'm sure glad I came back. You know?
Oh, we certainly are too, and we welcome you back anytime you can come.
Good.
But I've got an appointment in a few minutes, and I'm going to need to get out of here, so would you mind getting out of my parking slot?
Well, I don't mind at all, but I did have a real enjoyment of parking in your spot today.
Oh, I'm just joking. I really did, too. I'm glad you did.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. You can do anything but lay off of my blue suede shoe. But it's blue, blue, blue suede shoe.